From Jet 24, here's meteorologist Craig Flynn, your weather authority.
Good Saturday evening to you. Here's a look live right now. That is Edinburgh University in the Fighting Scott. We do have some wet weather that is building in. That's going to be around for the second half of the weekend here, kind of in and out. But let's recap July. So for the month, we had 3.21 inches total. And that's just a little bit below where we should be by 0.33, so really not all that bad. However, for the year, we do have a surplus, 23.15 the total for the year. That gives us a surplus of over 0.75 inches, and we will add to that as we head through the night tonight and into tomorrow. This is a look at the drought monitor. This is what we kind of keep an eye on as we head through the week. And notice parts of the area here in some of this yellow shading. So parts of Crawford County over into Warren County and even parts of Forest County in a moderate drought situation right now. Here along the shoreline and much of Erie County faring okay. Temperature-wise, because of the clouds and wet weather building in, so low 70s right now, Erie to Jamestown and Meadville at last check. Now let's bring you up to date on the tropics. So there's been a big controversy about this, okay, but we're going by the World Meteorological Organization and the National Hurricane Center for Hurricane Isaias. That's how it's pronounced. That's the definition. Don't email. Don't call me, okay? This is the way we pronounce this storm. And the update, as of 5 o'clock, it has been downgraded to a tropical storm, and a lot of that has to do with the interaction with the land here. So that type of scenario kind of shears the storms apart. So wind speeds are down to 70 miles an hour. It's drifting to the northwest at 10. Let's bring you up to date with the track, though, because it will be just scraping by the east coast of Florida here. It may re-strengthen into a minimal Category 1 hurricane as it crawls up the east coast of Florida, and then maybe coming ashore as a tropical storm somewhere near Wilmington, North Carolina, before moving out into the Canadian Maritimes. Probably not much of an issue for us here locally. All right, so watch Futurecast kind of fill in with some scattered downpours and storms as we head through tonight and then right through the second half of the weekend. It's not raining every hour all the time as we head into Sunday, but there will be some downpours and storms moving through, muggy as the warm front lifts through, and then the cold front will come through here as we head through the afternoon. Actually, two of them, one in the morning and then one again into the afternoon. So bottom line, plan on some wet weather at times Sunday. Jet pinpoint for the lakeshore then for tonight. Showers and thunder showers filling in. Lows 69 to 74. Areas south of I-90, muggy with rain and thundery downpours. Temperatures upper 60s to the low 70s. And for the Chautauqua-Allegheny region, more humidity building in with scattered showers, thunder showers, and some locally heavy rain embedded in any one of those showers or thunder showers. Same deal as we head into your Sunday, kind of in and out of wet weather at times. Still a chance Monday, still a chance Tuesday, and then we get a break here from the heat and humidity with highs back into the mid-upper 70s by midweek and a nice, cool, crisp night with low temperatures dropping into the upper 50s Wednesday night into Thursday. Looks real good, though, as we head into next weekend. YourErie.com. Click on weather for the latest updated forecast. Check out the weather cams and the interactive radar there as well. And you know, Brian, as we go into August now, those cooler nights will become more common.
Okay, and just one more time. How do you say the hurricane's name?
Isaias.
Isaias. And you say, your name is pronounced Craig. I'm saying that right?
Yes, okay. You are saying that one.
Good to know. I've always wanted to know. Thank you, Craig. Coming up,